Having all your eggs in one basket is definitely not a good idea, because if you drop the basket, all the eggs will break. That's why you need to have a portfolio, multiple strategies. And I'd like to show you right here in practice why a portfolio is so important. When you build some strategies, you never know in advance, even if you have a certain probability that maybe 70% of them will be profitable. You never have a real certainty, and you never know which one will be profitable and which one will be not. For example, here I have examples of three strategies. One that made almost $1,000, another one that's plus or minus zero, and the last one, which is really pretty profitable. All three of these strategies are part of this portfolio that you've already seen before. The result is very nice, 70% in some 10 months, which is highly above standard, but it shows that it can be done. As you can see, even this portfolio contains bad strategies that don't make money, mediocre strategies that are about zero, and excellent strategies that have nice profits. Let's build our own portfolio, but first, let's talk about what such a portfolio should look like. Let's put together multiple strategies that complement each other. That's the actual core of the portfolio, and that's how we will get more stable profits, like you can see here. The key thing we need to address is what's called correlation. The correlation of our strategies determines how similar they are. If we had two strategies that were exactly the same, their correlation would be one. If they were mirror reverse, like you see in this picture, then the correlation would be minus one. But we want the correlation to be less than 0.3, and we take 0.4 as the extreme limit. We want the correlation number to be as low as possible, ideally around 0.1. That's basically the ideal, because it's very likely that the strategies will be very diverse. Let's build a portfolio of strategies and show everything directly in StrategyQuant. It's not a big deal because you have the tools to do everything very simply. It took me less than 24 hours to build, and I have 183 strategies in the final version. You don't need that many. If you have 20, that should be enough. Just let the strategy build run overnight, and in the morning you will have all what you need. One important thing I almost forgot. If you have saved your strategies and don't have them right here in custom projects, apply them simply by going to retester in this section. If you have any strategies here, feel free to clear all and delete them, because we will work with the ones we created here in this course. And unless, of course, you have your own strategies in there, then click on the load button and load the strategies from your computer. And that's it. If you have more of them, just click Ctrl plus A, then open, and the strategies will open up nicely like that. After that, you're going to follow along with what I'm going to show you next in this video. So let's continue with our portfolio. Now, we can mark these strategies right away. Click on Portfolio, then on Merge Strategies, confirm it by clicking on OK, and you can see what the portfolio would look like if you were trading all the strategies at the same time. Especially, you can compute the correlation there. So let's wait until the 183 strategies are made into a portfolio, and then I will show the correlation of the strategies that we will have in it. The portfolio is built. It can take a while if you have a lot of strategies, so don't be like a surprise. Just take your time. For me, it took maybe a few minutes. And now you should see a strategy called portfolio. I got it right here in results. If I click on it and go to the tab overview, you can see it has 123,000 trades in total. It's a really big portfolio when you add it all together, which is why it takes longer to build. Here we have the equity curve, and this is the equity curve of the portfolio if we traded all the strategies at once. Of course, we don't want to trade all of them at once, because we don't know how they are going to complement each other, so we don't know the correlation. This curve already suggests to me that the strategies may not ideally complement each other. To give you an example, I will present you with another portfolio. I've already prepared that here in Portfolio Master. It contains the following strategies. Stock indexes have smaller profits, but that's beside the point now. That would be a longer explanation. But you can see that this portfolio has a nice rising and smoothed curve, which we can't say about that previous portfolio. We will also find that in the portfolio correlation section. I will choose a monthly or even a yearly analysis and compute a correlation. That's going to take some time. Once it's calculated, you will see a big table that shows how similar the strategies are on an annual basis, that is, how similar the annual profits of those strategies are. You can see that a lot of them have a high correlation, for example 0.76 or 0.84, which is almost 1-to-1. On the other hand, we have values like 0.18 or 0.13, and those are exactly the ones we want to have in the portfolio. We want strategies with low correlation, ideally even on a monthly basis, so that the strategies are as different as possible. This filtering is easily done here in the Portfolio Master section. Let's wait a moment while we calculate the monthly correlation. You can see that the correlation has dropped a bit, but it's still very high. So let's get to it. In Portfolio Master, I'm going to delete all the data banks. If you have anything in there, click on Clear All because we don't need them. In Custom Projects, select Final, check the box and put Move to Portfolio Master. Select Portfolio Master, not Portfolio Composer, and confirm OK. All strategies will move there. You see sample strategies, we have them here. We will need maybe 3 strategies to get started, which is a small number of combinations, and the test will be done quickly. We want the correlation to be as low as possible, so we will set a maximum of 0.1. Next, we don't want a negative correlation, and we will choose a monthly basis. So set the parameters as follows. Monthly profit loss, max correlation 0.1, and turn off negative correlation. Then click on progress and start it. We will simulate our portfolios fairly quickly. It should take a few minutes at most. You can see that it can test about 100 million combinations per hour, which is really very fast. The results will be then saved here in results, where you can find the portfolios that have been created. So we are going to wait a little while for that to compute. It took 44 seconds, but it didn't find anything. Never mind, the correlation of 0.1 was really very low, so we will set it to 0.2 and try it again. Let's wait another minute and see if it finds anything. And you can see it's already found something. It found us portfolios with a maximum correlation of 0.2, which is nice, and it found quite a few of them. So we will have plenty to choose from. Now we are going to pick a strategy from the portfolio to deploy to our test account. It found us a lot of portfolios and we only save the ones we need from that because we don't need more. You choose one portfolio from them to deploy to your test account. Feel free to pick the most profitable one to start with. So sort them by return drawdown ratio, use the equity chart, and see how the portfolio performs, including out of sample. You can turn off this red line simply by unchecking equity in the chart settings, and only your portfolio curve will be displayed. In short, choose the portfolio you like and that makes the most sense for you to deploy to a test account. We are in the testing phase now, so you can't make any super big important mistakes. Just pick a portfolio. I will pick this one, for example. Here in the tester, see if you happen to have any strategies. If you have any, feel free to delete them all again because we don't need them right now. Mark your portfolio, click on retest, and I usually chose to copy them. I copy it to retester, click on the portfolio and select split strategies. At this point, I have both the entire portfolio and the individual strategies that make up the portfolio in retester. Here you can see the 3 strategies that I have in the portfolio. And I can also look at the correlation here. I will have it calculated and you can see that the correlation is really low. If I then use the annual correlation just for interest, it's gone up a little bit, but it's still quite low on a monthly basis. That's enough for me personally, so I'm going to work with this portfolio. If you want, you can of course do that by choosing 5 strategies. You will have more possible combinations. If I delete all the results, because I already have the portfolio copy in retester, and I click on start, it will take longer to go through all the possible combinations, but it will find you a portfolio with more than 3 strategies if possible. I'm leaving that up to you. I found my portfolio of 3 strategies fairly quickly. If you don't find anything at a correlation of 0.2, go back and raise the correlation to 0.3. That should already find some portfolio, even if you only have 20 or 30 strategies in Simple Strategies tab. So that's it for this lesson. I look forward to seeing you on the next video.